Hey guys, Nick here. So today I'm going to address an argument that we've often seen happen in the comments section of our social media posts about using a girl's hair tie for a ponytail to secure their radio mic to their body armor or their uniform. There seems to be a whole tribe of these people that like this, so let's do a little comparison to the mic loop. So here's an example of one setup I've seen people use with a standard police uniform and using a hair tie. What I've seen them do is lace the hair tie through the buttonhole of a shirt and then just simply put their radio mic through the hair tie and allow an elasticy rebound effect to secure their mic. As far as outer carriers and tactical carriers go, I've seen them use the mic tabs like this or Molly on their tactical carriers and pretty much do it the same way as they would do it on the uniform shirt, as putting the entire microphone through the hair tie to secure it. So I just want to see what each one of them can take and hold. My test today is going to consist of 3 kettlebells, 25 pounds, 40 pounds, and 60 pounds, and I'm going to hook each one of them up to each kettlebell and see which one they'll hold. Let's start with the mic loop. So starting off, I've looped the mic loop around the handle of the 25 pound kettlebell, and given my weak grip strength, I'm able to pick it up off the ground and swing it, and it holds on securely. Moving on to the 40 pounder, I do the same thing, loop it around the handle of the kettlebell and pick it up off the ground. This one's a little harder for my grip, but I think I managed somehow, and the mic loop handles the 40 pound kettlebell pretty easily. All right, let's move on to the 60 pound kettlebell. I'm gonna set it up the same way. Gonna loop the mic loop around the handle, and as you can see, there is no special tools holding on to the Velcro strip. It's only my meager grip, and let's see what it'll do. Picks it up, swings it around, no issues. Now, just for fun, I wanted to see if it would hold 2 60-pound kettlebells. Having quite a challenge picking these guys up off the ground with just my grip, but as you can see, it looks to be that the mic loop is actually holding the 120 pounds up. I had a little grip slippage. Let's give it a second go around with the same mic loop. 120 pounds of kettlebells being held by the mic loop. Look at that. All right, let's move on to the hair tie and see what kind of damage it'll do to these kettlebells. Now, full disclosure on these videos here with the 25 pounder, I almost didn't include this video because it shows my awesome slip-on shoe in the video, but as you can see here, the 25 pound kettlebell is no match for the hair tie, swinging, stretching, and all its greatness. So in order to get my measly shoe out of the frame on the second video, I decided to shoot it again and test it in the same exact manner, wrapping the hair tie around the handle of the 25 pounder and giving it another pull for the shot. And there it went. So I think it's plain to see that the hair tie is meant to do just what its name says it is, hold hair. It's meant to hold a ponytail, whether it's male or female, not meant to secure a radio mic or any form of communication during an altercation, foot pursuit, struggle, manhunt. It's meant to hold hair. But to each their own, use the gear that you want to use. However, if you'd like to keep your mic secured, use the mic loop.